I got this from the Tumblr. They didn't keep watching. So I'm using the Anastasia Novena palette, and I'm starting off with the shade D1, and I'm just using that as a brow highlight. Now I'm gonna go in with the shade B3, and I'm gonna put that in the crease and just start to get like that nice warm transition. Also, I'm gonna dip back in to the color again just to kind of build up the color. So these colors you can honestly build up, and it's a pigment shade, so do not be mistaken. Next, we're gonna go in with the shade D1 again. Well, D1, I'm sorry, D1. And I'm just gonna slowly blend this all out. Now I'm going in with the shade D5. In D5, I'm just kind of like deepening it up. So now you can see it's really giving me that nice warmness that you want for like a bronzy skin tone look. Next, I grabbed the shade B5. Now this just gave it like a little bit of shadowing. It's definitely optional, y'all. You can still skip out on this step, but I just like the little bit of shadow it gave me. I didn't want to go too smoky. And now I'm gonna go in with that shimmery shade, and that was the shade B4. So I just kind of wet my brush a little bit, and I'm gonna apply it on the lid. Now this is gonna be kind of like the base color, but you see it's very bronzy. I would say if you're around my skin tone or any skin tone, honestly, this will look really beautiful on. Now we're gonna go in with the shade E3, and I use the Too Faced glitter glue to kind of help make the glitter stick. And honestly, this just amplifies the whole look. Like, this is what summertime fine looks like. And the glitter glue, truthfully, you will have no fallout whatsoever. So I would say definitely apply glitter glue. We're gonna start working on complexion. This is the Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. I'm putting it all over my face to give me like a nice smooth canvas. Especially in the summertime, I like love a pore filling primer. This is the Milk Foundation. Sorry for that pause. This is the Milk Foundation. I'm gonna put this all over my skin. Now, I don't know why on camera it was looking very golden, but it does match. I would say it's probably just the lighting, but it definitely matches. So we're gonna put this all over our face. This is also gonna give you like a soft matte. So if you're super oily, I would say maybe mattify your skin a little bit more. This is more like a soft matte or like a satin type of foundation. It's not too matte, but it's definitely not. It's nice in the middle. Now I'm gonna go in with the Pat McGrath concealer. This concealer, what it does for me, maybe this is gonna kind of like correct my skin, even me out really well. So I'm just using this to kind of even out my skin tone. And if you want to see like more of a in-depth opinion review, don't forget to check out my Pat McGrath review video that I did, and it'll tell you like my thoughts on the concealer, foundation, and color. But I'm just gonna blend it all out with my beauty blender, and you can see it's just making my skin look nice and even overall. I don't really have dark circles or anything, so that's never an issue of mine. Now I'm going back with an oldie but goodie, MAC Prep and Prime and Bright Forecast, because I really wanted to just brighten it up a little bit. It was looking like one dimension to me. So this gave me like that nice brightness. I feel like we have that bronze look with a nice bright under eye. Thank you. little tiny brush. I don't remember which number this is, but any little tiny brush like this will work. And just kind of take your time, and you're gonna just shape out your nose. Also, don't forget to go back in and like really diffuse it so it's not extremely harsh. Unless you like the really harsh look, then I mean, I would say keep it, but just go back in and diffuse everything out. You're gonna see now I'm gonna go in with the Too Faced translucent powder, and I'm just gonna take it along the sides of my nose, and that'll also kind of like carve out the nose contour and just clean it up. I really like to like bake just to clean up any of those harsh lines and just make everything stand out and look even more snatched. So yeah, so I'm gonna go in with the Too Faced translucent powder. Also, all the names of the colors and the products and stuff will be listed in the description box. I'm going back in with the first shade that I used previously, and I'm going to put it underneath my eye. I didn't want it to be too smoky. I really wanted to keep everything nice and warm. And if you notice, I was going with like more of those warm orangey type of colors because I feel like that's super flattering on this skin tone, my skin tone, even medium tan to deep. These are really nice flattering colors. Now I'm going in with the Marc Jacobs liner, and it's just a really nice brown color. Once again, not too smoky. I'm gonna use the Anastasia shade B1, and I wet it a little bit just to give me that nice inner corner highlight that I love. I also took it down the bridge of my nose and on the tips. And this blush right here, I don't know why I didn't show it, but it is a Milani baked blush. Not too sure if they still make it, but I will list it. And this is the new Fenty highlighter. Now, fun fact, if you want the highlight to be a little bit more muted, you would use like the more fan brush. If you want it like to really give you that glow, I would say go in with the blush, a brush like this. Now I'm just going back in again with the Pat McGrath powder just to kind of help re-brighten it. That one, to me, gives me a really nice brightness underneath the eye. I'm aligning my lips with the NYX Urban Cafe lip liner. This is a staple. I'm pretty sure I'm going to use it in like 50 more videos because this is my go-to lip look that I'm about to do right now. And I'm just, yeah, going to align my lips, make them look nice and luscious. And then we're going to get ready to go in with a nude. Alright y'all, so the nude that I went in is the KBD Bow and Arrow, and this is by far my favorite liquid lipstick nude color. I just love it. I love how it looks, and I'm gonna blend everything in with a lip brush so it looks nice and diffused. With this look, you can definitely do lip gloss. I opted to keep it more matte so it'll last long. Now you're just gonna spray your face with your Urban Decay Z Slick, and that is it, mamas. You are ready to go. Voila.
High fashion, like Goya, G-Wagon, or the Rover. I put some ice on you cause you got a cold.